Dearest gentle reader, did you miss me?
Sweaty!
I'm Nicola Coughlin.
I'm Claudia Jesse. So we are going to give you an exclusive look at some of the new sets from Bridgerton 2.
And some of the old sets, because why not? Come on! This is Will's club, where the guys hang out.
Mr. Bridgerton, you honour me with your presence.
Being cool dudes.
Making deals, although girls are allowed here.
Apparently, not that anyone's invited us, which is rude.
Imagine just a couple of teenagers in a bar around loads of grown men.
It's based at a Las Vegas nightclub.
And there's real gold in here.
Yeah.
Like this stuff.
So that's real. That's probably worth about a good £950.
And then here's the bar. All right, Guff.
We will have two wines, good sir.
I'll have 10 of your finest pints of beer. Thank you, sir. And that's the club.
And that's the club. I think we couldn't have done a better job of explaining this. This is based on like two or three real streets in Bath. And this is Spoon Liquors. Do you want to come in? Come on. Fake cakes. They're generally...
Oh, wow.
Styrofoam, yeah.
Oh, no, that's, yeah. Do you reckon people would have gone on loads of like tea shop dates after Bridgerton season one? Because they thought...
Oh my God, I hope so.
And now we can take you to the Modiste, which we know more about because we've actually spent time
there. We've
actually
been there.
This is another recreated shop from Bath, halfway through season one. We lost the shop and they rebuilt it. So Madame Delacroix owns this place, so this is where she does her servicing of people.
Address, D-R-E...
Without giving too much away, like, season two, what sort of role does Madame Delacroix play?
Huge.
But yeah, we can't say too much, but I think people will be shocked by Madame Delacroix in season two. She obviously doesn't make these costumes, but we do have an incredible costume team led by Sophie who make everything from absolute scratch.
So the most important thing in the Modiste, you may not know this, is this, because this is my mum's favourite type of pottery. It's called Bleak. And it's got the little mark on the bottom.
Is it Irish?
It's Irish, yeah. And she collects it.
No way.
And she absolutely loves it. So it was the best day of her life when I sent her a picture. I was like, guess what's on set?
Oh, let's just take that then.
That's from my mum. They want her to have this. So now...
Let's just take it.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Welcome to Lady Danbury's house. We're going to go check out the drawing room.
Look at her. She is beauty. She is grace. She's serving all that face.
The woman who does like these amazing paintings of all of us is also Lady Whistledown's hand. So anytime you see Lady Whistledown writing, it's her hand, which is pretty cool. It's not Nicola's hand.
Well,
or Julie Andrews' hand. Oh, you've done one hand. Let's go to the drawing room.
This is stunning and yet another place that Eloise and Penelope never get invited to.
Lady Danbury, oh, how delightful it is to see you.
And you.
It's really nice. It's very pink. Definitely the most feminine house.
Yeah, I'd say so. What do you think your drawing room would look like when Penelope's like a grown-up? What would you want?
Oh, when she's a grown-up. Well, I'm hoping she's going to marry Colin. So it's going to be a blend of the Bridgerton and Feathering Star, which will be disgusting.
This one's beautiful.
This one's lovely.
Thanks for coming with us on this tour. I hope you
come again sometime. Bridgerton season two.
Now you get out of here, you.
You get out of here. You go.